Maybe there's some way to turn the elevator on.
Hi, Caitlin. I'm leaving this hole. Thanks for helping me out yesterday. I'm so excited that I'm gonna be able to finally start over again. I'll call you as soon as I settle in Seattle. I'm leaving you the key to the apartment in the drawer with the label. I don't trust the doorman.
Goddamn dolls.
Thank you.
piece of junk. This place. Maybe a little too well. Of all the things that concern us, the most characteristic is the feeling of guilt. Every one of us has done some harm. Sometimes more, sometimes less. The kind of harm that leaves a mark, and the kind that goes unseen. I'm not special in this case. I've done a lot of things I regret. Some of them, I can't even forgive myself. I hear something. Where did it go? Run, Matt. Run, you bastard. Run if you want to live. Bright ideas? Finally. I remember my father used to say, we're on a path of no return. And even though he was an old bastard, I think he was right. But what he didn't say is that at the end of that path lurks something unsettling, something dark, hidden in our minds or hearts. It slowly pushes us to the edge of ourselves and causes us to no longer actually be ourselves, but something different.
This is the church, and this is the steeple. Open the door and see all the people. Here is the parson going upstairs, and here are we. You still can't see us? Wake up already! Open your eyes, you fucking coward!
Cold. I need to move. remember a long time ago, when I was a kid, I would wander around these caves with my friend Ron. Ron was always quiet and calm, but I swear, as soon as we got further inside, something would possess him. That strange mystic voice would awake inside of him. I'd call it nature, or I don't know. I have no idea what to call it. Anyway, he would get down there and Ron, normally an incredibly quiet kid, would start telling stories about monsters lurking around. He would say how this nutty old woman who lived nearby, we called her Old Libby, thought she was a witch, would take the children she caught stealing apples from her garden to the caves. And of course, whoever entered the caves never came out again. Which was stupid, obviously, since we would go in and out all the time. Anyway, that was one of my favorite childhood memories. But this town destroys every good memory. One night, Ron disappeared, and no one ever saw him again. Just a few hours before that, he was taking apples from Old Libby's garden. No, not him.
Oh, we've missed you so much.